1969. Nixon was president. The Beatles record their final album together, and the words, "One giant leap for mankind," become a part of our history forever. It was also in 1969 that, by chance, a Fort Worth oilman walked into the Tarrant County Convention Center. The man was C.J. Red Davidson, and the event was the 41st Texas FFA Convention. Oh, and that's where our story starts. Wait. We need a better song here.
He was just inspired by what he was seeing. They were poised, articulate, and he thought, these are some good kids.
So, CJ opened his checkbook and planted the financial seed that would grow for years to come.
FFA provides role models for young people, and those role models are ag teachers and the FFA officers.
By now you might be wondering, what is FFA? What does it stand for? Why do I care? Well, there's a good answer for all of that.
Agriculture affects everybody. We all have to eat, we all have to be clothed. We are all a part of agriculture.
And who better to carry on the tradition, innovation, and evolution of agriculture than, you guessed it, the future farmers of America.
Let me ask you a question. You know how FFA began?
In 1925, four agricultural education teachers established an organization for young farm boys that also would teach citizenship and leadership skills.
FFA was founded in 1928, and it prepares students for over 300 careers in agriculture. Basically, they take classroom learning and apply it to the real world, building future leaders of our world.
Little did they know the concept would evolve into one of the finest youth organizations in the world and establish the Future Farmers of America.
The year is 1987. Reagan's in office, the Simpsons are on TV, and the FFA leadership recognized that for this thing to continue to grow, they needed a long-term financial plan to manage the C.J. Red Davidson endowments. And I guess that's really where our story starts. The role of the foundation was simple: to help grow Texas's greatest resource, its youth.
Texas FFA needs our support. Why? For the future of young men and women like these two guys.
With Jay Udy accepting the position as the first chairman, it was time to get to work.
Our focus really was to support the work of local chapters, because that's really where the magic happens.
Hard work is done year after year to help grow scholarship opportunities and other means of capital. It's the job of the FFA Foundation to protect the strength and future of the Texas FFA.
The foundation is one that works behind the scenes diligently to provide so many opportunities.
We've seen a lot of changes, a lot more scholarships available out there to the kids.
One of our real challenges that we had in FFA is, you know, we didn't have a great big staff.
Fast forward to 2000, and Aaron Alejandro accepts a job as the executive director.
Well, when I came on board, one of the first things I did in this assessment that I was discussing was look at who our sponsors are. Who are our sponsors? So one of our largest sponsors at the time was Ford Motor Company.
One day a group showed up and said, we want to encourage the Texas Ford dealers and Ford Motor Company to get involved with our capital campaign.
In the history of the FFA up until that point, this was going to be the largest corporate ask that was ever done.
So at that moment, he kind of raised up in his seat and began his sales pitch.
I remember delivering the proposal to Mitchell.
My initial response was,
they support at the national FFA level, and wasn't sure that they were going to do anything at the state level. I just remember looking at Mitchell saying, you know, we drove all the way from Austin. And something tells me if you'll just flip that proposal up to page 12, that you might find value here.
I listened, I reviewed it.
He closed the proposal. He kept it.
It made sense.
On stage of that convention that year, 2 hours before the foundation was to give a report, I received a phone call from Ford Motor Company. They had honored our request of $1.3 million, the first million-dollar gift in the history of the FFA.
From here, the foundation didn't slow down. In 2005, they announced they hit their 3-year goal of $3.5 million after raising $4.2 million. In 2006, the foundation secured the FFA's first title co-sponsors for the state convention. And it wasn't just corporations who wanted to help out. In 2005, rancher Richard Walworth made Texas FFA history by becoming the foundation's all-time leading contributor with gifts totaling more than $1.5 million.
The strategy worked.
Many people probably don't know the impact of the FFA Foundation.
The FFA is creating the people through those events, but the foundation program is making sure that those people in future generations are going to be there.
They see all the kids in the blue and gold jacket, but they don't know what's behind the scene and why that's possible.
A lot happens.
We did some things that most people didn't think we could do. I'll give you an example of that. Is
the LEAD program for teachers, providing them another opportunity to advance themselves. What about the legislative LEAD and giving the insights into what goes on the Hill?
The foundation has found its way in dealing with sponsors better, dealing with teachers better.
Don't forget the Foundation Ambassador or Ford Leadership Scholars Program. Whether it's helping lead the state convention or giving back to their community, students are prepared for their future.
It's truly fascinating to see how big these students will think.
What the foundation does is basically keeps all of those parts moving.
Amongst many other things. But if there's one thing you should take away from what the FFA Foundation does, it's
the passion that is behind the scenes that a lot of people don't see. There's a reason why they've been so successful in raising money over the past 20 plus years. There's a reason why one in every six FFA members across the nation is right here in Texas.
Well, yeehaw, y'all. I couldn't have said it better myself.
If FFA was important in the beginning, and it's still important today, don't you think it'll be just as important in the future?
I like to compare myself to a patchwork quilt. I know that's corny, but there are so many pieces of me that so many different people, contributed to that made me into the person that I am today.
Right, so today I have Aaron Alejandro on the line, and he's the Executive Director of Texas FFA Foundation. Aaron, welcome to the show.
Hey, good to see you. Thanks for the invite. This is awesome.
In terms of the Texas FFA, I don't think there's any other organization that promotes students the way they do and offers the opportunities.
I tell people all the time that whether we're talking about Texas, California, America, or the world, we have three vital and renewable resources: youth, agriculture, and leadership.
I found my belonging through the FFA, and I didn't have that before.
I've grown as a person, as an individual, as a friend, as a family member.
It's been my whole life. It's what I've done for 42 years now, and I love it.
Our mission at the Texas FFA Foundation combines all three. We form not only well-rounded leaders today, but dynamic influencers tomorrow. Have some brilliant minds, and I'm excited about the mission that we have because we get to empower those young people that will lead into the future.
The essence of leadership is to plant trees under whose shade you may never sit. I'm proud of the work that we've done at the Texas FFA Foundation and with Texas Team at GED, because we are planting trees. And I'm hopeful that the result of everything that we do is we make our communities, our state, and our country a better place to live, work, and raise our children.
The year is now, and the mission still the same. With over 155,000 members and 1,082 local chapters, we can't help but think, if CJ could see what the Texas FFA has become today, he would be pretty proud.
That, ladies and gentlemen, is our future. You've just heard people you know and trust tell you how FFA helped them. Now the question is, what's the future worth?